Welcome back to SnowRunner on Hard Mode. At the end of the last episode, we completed the Long Bridge task on the White Valley map. We're yet to visit the Pedro Bay map, and there are a few tasks to open the roads in Pedro Bay, which are the next main priority. Along the way, we can also complete the lumber mill supplies contract. We'll need to pick up 2 loads of fuel, 1 load of metal beams, 1 load of small pipes, and 4 loads of service spare parts and deliver them to the sawmill in Mountain River. We can pick up the fuel here in White Valley, as the fuel station is not far out of the way. Top up again from the scout fuel carrier. With the fuel on board, we can head to the factory to pick up the metal beams. Next stop is the sawmill in Mountain River.
Thank you.
We can now head to the warehouse to pick up the small pipes. After topping up with fuel again, the next stop is the service hub for the 4 loads of service spare parts. To save making an extra trip, I'll pack 3 loads of service spare parts into the trailer and then carry another on top using the crane to hold it down. We can now head to the lumber mill to complete the contract. To open the first two roads in Pedro Bay, we'll need to take along 6 loads of wooden planks. I'll pack 5 loads in the trailer and carry an extra load on top. Thank you. The first task we'll need to complete is Morrison's landslide, which requires two loads of wooden planks. We'll need to reverse the truck to get back to the drop-off zone. With that complete, I'll repack the trailer, then we can pick up the dangerous route task. We'll need to deliver the remaining four loads of wooden planks to the bridge. With that complete, there is one more vehicle we can discover and add to our fleet for the Alaska region, the ANK MK38. I'll drop off the trailer here at the oil field, then after topping up with fuel, I'll head up the path to find the ANK. We've now discovered all the vehicles in Alaska and reached rank 21. I'll jump in the ANK and run it back to the Northport garage. The ANK comes equipped with a custom set of off-road tyres, permanent all-wheel drive and diff lock, and is one of the best American trucks for getting through tough sections in mud and snow, but it can be unstable with raised suspension. and it cannot have any form of add-ons except for its standard side bed. With the off-road tyres, we'll need to take care on the icy sections of road. Situations like this are why I much prefer to use chain tyres in Alaska. It was lucky I wasn't carrying much speed, as the brakes are pretty much useless on ice. With all the vehicles discovered, next on the list is to open up some more watchtowers and find some upgrades, but I'll save that for the next episode. Thanks for watching.